My name is Courtney Coffey, president of the Xi Zeta Omega chapter of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, and Chairman of the Board of Directors for the Ivy Foundation, our event sponsor. On behalf of the nearly 300 members of our chapter, I'd like to thank you for joining us for our annual prayer breakfast. I hope today's message on perseverance encourages everyone watching to continue to strive for their hopes, dreams, and goals, and have confidence knowing that the fruits of their labor will soon come to harvest. I'd like to thank today's speakers, performers, and our planning committee for this wonderful morning of inspiration, celebration, and motivation. Thank you, and enjoy the breakfast.
Good morning to each and every one of you. Let us prepare our hearts and minds to go before the Lord with a word of prayer. Come on, let's pray. Eternal God, our Creator, we come into your presence in a spirit of thanksgiving and gratitude. God, we thank you for being sovereign in our lives and not just seeing what our needs are, but also responding and meeting each and every one of our needs. We thank you, God, because we know that you look down through the ages from the beginning of time down to the year 2022, and you saw that your people would be facing challenges, and you heard their cries, and you responded in a special way. We thank you that part of your response was to assemble a group of unique women to become a part of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, Incorporated. And we thank you, God, for calling out these women by name to be a part of the Xi Zeta Omega chapter and to have impact in the DC area. So, God, we pray that you would move by your Holy Spirit in this gathering today. And we pray that you would move in such a way that everyone assembled here would hear the clarion call to rise up as an overcomer. We thank you, God, that you are reminding us that in you, we are indeed overcomers. And so we pray that through every song lifted, every word spoken, every thought expressed, someone would be reminded that they are empowered by your Spirit to rise up, and that when they rise up, they will set the example for someone else to rise up as well. And we pray, oh God, that we will walk in the purpose that you have assigned to each and every one of us individually and collectively in such a way that reminds others that we are overcomers and that they can be too. Now, God, we turn this worship experience over to you, and we pray that you would be glorified in everything that we do. We thank you, God, and we praise you, and it is in your masterful and matchless name that we pray, and our hearts collectively declare amen, amen, and thank God.
James 1:12, blessed is the one who perseveres under trial, because having stood the test, that person will receive the crown of life that the Lord has promised to those who love him. Amen.
Good morning, I'm Kendase Jackson, event chairman for the 4th Annual Prayer Breakfast hosted by Xi Zeta Omega Chapter. Today is special in that today's theme is to rise up overcomer. It is so vital due to all the challenges that we currently face. However, this event is a celebration and is an opportunity to reflect, to uplift, as well as to be resolved to rise up and to overcome. Our program committee thought that this would be a vital event as well as a beautiful event where members of our organization can come together with the community to worship and to pray. We hope that you are inspired, uplifted, and resolved to rise up and to overcome against the injustices, inequalities, any differences, and as well as any of the issues that your community currently faces. Today, may you be resolved to rise up and to overcome.
Broken down and tired of living life on a merry-go-round, and you can't find a fighter but a seed in you, so we will work it out and move. though you feel like dying. But I promise we will bring the world to its feet and move mountains. We'll bring them to its feet and move mountains. And we'll
morning, notable North Atlantic Region Soul Roars. It is indeed my pleasure to support Xi Zeta Omega's inspirational program this morning so we can all be inspired to rise up and overcome. The Lord has blessed us with our illustrious sisterhood and allowed us to gather today. For that, we are thankful. Despite COVID, the multiple pandemics that we've been battling, and the current state of affairs of our country, our great sisterhood continues to rise up. We must remember our ancestral lineage of women who were on the front lines. They rose up and left us in a blueprint of how to overcome. So Soul Roars, are you ready? I believe Xi Zeta Omega is ready to carry on that legacy of the first administration on the front lines. As many of you know, the first administration is built on the principles of fellowship, innovation, respect, service, and thrive. Adhering to these principles while relying on our faith and our mission, we are already equipped to rise up. You have taken the first step by coming together today and anchoring this program in such a powerful word. James chapter 1, verse 12 says, "Blessed is the one who perseveres under trial, because you have stood the test. That person will receive the crown of life that the Lord has promised to those who love him." Soul Roars, we have persevered under the trials of COVID, and Alpha Kappa Alpha continues to persevere on the front lines of the struggle. Soul Roars, put your crowns on and recommit and dedicate yourself to serving our community and this region with intention and love. Are you ready, Soul Roars? As I unveil the first administration, I charge you to join me in finishing out 2022 with boldness, and hopefulness. Xi Zeta Omega Soars, I know you are excited to learn about Madam Supreme's new programs and how we individually and collectively can support her administration. I believe Xi Zeta Omega Soars understand the assignment and are equipped to rise up and overcome. But if you're weary,
Remember the words in our hymn, we help each other. Soul Roars, we are sisters above all else, so breathe and call a Soul Roar. Lean on a Soul Roar, she's got you. Believe the words when we sing, hearts that are loyal. Join the prayer call. Our chaplain and prayer team has you. Soul Roars, it is through God's divine order that each of you are here today to receive the charge. Our beloved Soul Roar, Maya Angelou, reminds us that bringing the gifts that my ancestors gave, I am the dream and the hope of the slave. And she ends this quote by saying, I rise, I rise, I rise. African Americans and women in particular are destined for greatness and always overcome seemingly insurmountable obstacles. Our ancestors have gifted us the tools. Our founders, our incorporators, our leadership, your charter members, and generations of soars who have come before us have gifted us the tools. Let us now rise up and get to work. When we gather in sisterhood, follow our faith, and uphold our principles, we shut down the naysayers, the haters, and the non-believers. We are the notable North Atlantic region, the birthplace of the Black sorority tradition. We are the first and the finest. And as I close, I go back to the scripture, James chapter 1, verse 12. I charge you, soars, to lift your heads up, stand tall, put on your crowns, and act like the queens you are. Soul Roars, rise up, overcomers.
Thank you so much. We hope you are enjoying today's fourth annual prayer breakfast. And right now, because we are not able to meet in person as of yet, we would love to give the money that would have been spent on food to one of our lovely community partners, Miss Alicia Washington. The Executive Director of Deeds of Kindness Outreach Services is here with us to kindly and graciously accept the donation. Ms. Washington, please share with us more about what Deeds of Kindness does and what they're about in the community.
Good morning, ladies. I'm Alicia Washington, speaking on behalf of Deeds of Kindness Outreach Services. Our nonprofit organization is located in Ward 6 in the District of Columbia, and we provide various services to individuals suffering with mental health challenges, those dealing with substance use and misuse, and anyone in need of essential resources such as clothing, toiletries, and food. We work with community notables such as So Others May Eat, the Psychiatric Institute of Washington, HIPS, Foundation for a Drug-Free World, as well as the fabulous Soras of Psi Zeta Omega. We have fed and served over 37,000 at-risk and needy individuals in the DMV. We want to thank you, ladies, for all you do in the community, and thank you for allowing us the privilege to partner with you over the last several years. You all are proven leaders in the areas of charitable giving, and it is an honor to serve with you. On behalf of our CEO, Marcus Carr, management and staff of Deeds of Kindness Outreach Services, we send prayers and best wishes for a spiritually impactful prayer breakfast. Peace and blessings.
Thank you so much.
Statistics said I should be dead by now. Trouble and wars all around. The doctors surely had counted me out. After all I had to face, you've been there. And your tongue in every way.
Are there any survivors in the house tonight?
Now I can go on.
Come on, clap your hands with me.
I didn't think I could make it. Statistics said I should be.
trouble and wars all around. The doctor surely had counted me out. After all, you've been there and you turned it in every way. Hand on it. I won't cease, I'll just praise.
I won't cease, I'll just praise. My way, ooh, that's how I'll take it.
When something stands in the way.
When something stands in my way. I know I can make it.
I won't cease, I'll just praise.
Greetings to my sorors and esteemed guests, giving honor to God and thanksgiving for this wonderful chapter and the leadership that it has, and for this prayer breakfast committee for inviting me to share with you the word of God from the book of James, surrounded by your theme, which is Rise Up, Overcomer. James 1 in the New International Version says, "Blessed is the one who perseveres under trial, because having stood the test, the person will receive the crown of life that the Lord has promised to those who love him." For the time that is mine, I'd like to share three reasons why you are an overcomer. This verse found in James is in James's letter to the body of believers on how to endure life's trials. What's called the paramosos in Greek, it is specifically the testing of the faithful. But at the time of the writing of this letter to the church, it is still a very new and young church. So these Christians were met with persecution. In the text, Jesus, the Son of God, has ascended to heaven, and the author, James, the brother of Jesus, writes this letter in Greek after having endured himself the suffering of those same disciples that followed Jesus. And he's giving us guidance on enduring temptation. A lesson is given for all followers on how to use the Spirit in a hostile world. James, a follower of the way, describes futile circumstances and yet favor to come. His goal is to solidify and transform the church by providing this pastoral response. The response is one of a teacher and one of an elder, one who is giving thought to how to mentor believers. And he stresses the concerns on how to handle our barriers and challenges wherever we may find them, wherever we may find tests and temptation. He speaks with the authority of a leader to instruct and encourage the community to have deeds and faith that accompany Christian lifestyle. Close analysis of this text tells us how the disciples are to get a deeper understanding of what it means to be in the way. And it does mean that you're going to have to overcome some things. Pastor James uses the teachings of Jesus the Christ to aid believers in their own faith development. James counsels believers to be patient, even long-suffering. And that's gritty advice to live by. That's gritty advice for us to live like Christ. And isn't that what we endure today? This is also where we get the statement that we are to live as servants of God. And it introduces to us the fact that Christ suffered. And not only did he suffer for who he was, he suffered for what he did. Can I remind you that people will hate on you just because? People will hate on you because they don't like your name, they don't like anything about you, or they don't like what it is God is blessing you with. But God's word tells us in that even if you do suffer for doing what is right, you will be blessed. So don't fear and don't be intimidated, but know that you will suffer for doing what's right sometimes. And I know I'm speaking to somebody this morning because I know what it feels like to suffer. I know that there's good news though, that after you suffer for doing good works, that you will be rewarded. Your story might include somebody neglecting you. Your story might include somebody rejecting you. Your story might include somebody hating on you or talking about you. But the good news is that you will be rewarded for your good works. Lord knows external hostilities come at us from every direction. I don't know about you, but this pandemic has been rough. Some of us are still showing up broken and some of us not healed. But how did James get to this point in this text? At first, he did not even believe his brother, his only brother, had resurrection power. But then Jesus showed up to him and the other apostles, and he did believe. Won't Jesus show up for us? Hasn't Jesus showed up for you? In the beginning of this letter, we are told to count it all joy, but trials don't feel joyous. There might be revelation, but there often isn't joy associated with trials. And the old people used to say, you just keep on living. We can expect bad things, or we can expect trials and temptations to come. Daily temptations will be faced in our business lives, our professional lives, our personal lives. And so there it is. There is the question for us. How do we respond to fierce, ferocious, and forceful storms of our lives? And that brings us to our verse for today. Why can you rise up and overcome? Well, the first reason you can do it is because you've been blessed. The first word of verse 12 tells us that you are blessed. When we see our present, our today, as God activity in our lives over time, we can see that we have been blessed. When I look back over my life, and I know you know, when you look back over your life and you think things over, you can truly say that you've been blessed. And I've got a testimony, you've got a testimony, and we all have a testimony. And not just one, but another and another. And the funny thing is when you experience being blessed and forgiven by our God, you will worship him. This pandemic has taught us some things, and we've been blessed with the wisdom to keep going. The wisdom that is the divine gift of God. The wisdom that gives us practical insight. The wisdom that enables us to face trials with Jesus' joy. Even the wisdom to worship. We can say we are blessed with patience and perseverance, blessed with good and perfect gifts, blessed with the word of truth, unwavering faith. And this verse tells us we are not to doubt, but we are blessed. Happy is the one. Blessed is the one. Fortunate is the one. Congratulated is the one. The one who perceives and perseveres. The one who perseveres and endures trials. So not only can we rise up and be overcomers because we're blessed, we can rise up and be overcomers because we have tolerated the test. And so here it is. We are called to maintain love. We are called to uphold, preserve, sustain, keep, and take care of each other and our communities. And I know what you're thinking. I barely like most people. But when you do this, when you love and live through your trials, you will be fundamentally defined as a servant of the Most High God, and your reward will be in heaven. This word, it inclines people to forgive and forget offenses against themselves and against each other, to cover and conceal the shortcomings of others. For some of you holy people that love everybody all the time, keep on doing what you're doing. But for some of us, we got to work at it. And that means when those challenging coworkers are disrespecting you and they have done it in the past, guess what? You overcame it. You tolerated the test. When Sister Shirley took your parking spot, you overcame it. You tolerated that test. Your family members that are plucking your last reserve nerve, you overcame it. You tolerated the test. That friend that is just not a good friend, guess what? You tolerated that test. You overcame it. You tolerated the test. And you were blessed. If someone tried to tell your story, if somebody tried to tell you what you've been through, they would have to admit that you have tolerated your tests and you have survived your trials. They couldn't tell it all because only you know all the tests and trials you have endured. So you can rise up and you can overcome because you've been blessed and because you've tolerated the test. But finally, because you've been promised a crown. The scripture says right here in verse 12 that you have been promised a crown of victory. You can claim victory. You have believed and not doubted, been tested and been approved, cast down but not destroyed. The crown of life is referred to in this verse in James 1. It is bestowed upon you. Those who persevere and those who have bared the weight under the trials. Jesus references himself that this crown, when he gives it to you, it will be the church, not to be afraid, but you are to suffer and be faithful unto the point of death. And he says that he will give us a crown. You can have a sense of satisfaction today, knowing that you have proved a level of your own spiritual maturity. And maturity usually means perfection. But what you have done is taken your faith and you have put it to work and you have been tested. Your faith has been supported by your prayers. The prayers of the righteous always availeth much. Anything is either God sent or God permitted. And so as God is answering your prayers and as God is giving you peace, God is also setting you up for a crown of life. After the turbulence of last year and after the uncertainty of this pandemic, after the violent storms, God sends streams of poured out blessings. Psalm 65 says it this way: God will crown your year with God's goodness, and God's paths drip with abundance. So instead of dripping with ice, you'll be dripping with the abundance of God. He will open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing so that you won't even have room enough to receive it. It's because of your love relationship with God that you will get this crown of life. All of the hardships of the faithful win a crown. A crown represents legitimacy. A crown represents power and triumph and authority, victory, glory, and honor. And you have maintained your faithfulness and been blessed through your trials. You can rise up and overcome. You can rise up and overcome because you've tolerated the test. You can rise up and overcome because the Lord has been real good to you and the Lord has blessed you along the way. The Lord bless you real good, overcomer. If you receive this good gospel, that means that you've been blessed. If you receive this good gospel, then that means you've tolerated the test. And if you receive this good gospel, it means you will receive the crown of life. Amen. Amen and amen.
We worship you. Hallelujah. morning. I am Tracy Harrison, First Vice President and Program Chairman of Xi Zeta Omega Chapter. Thank you for joining us for this morning's fourth virtual prayer breakfast. We hope that you heard something today that will help you feel restored, refreshed, renewed, and uplifted. My heartfelt thanks and congratulations to Candace A. Jackson and the committee who worked so hard to bring us this blessed event. You will be able to continue to watch this event on our YouTube channels, and we ask that you will follow us on all of our social media channels to continue to see the great work that Xi Zeta Omega Chapter is doing. Thank you again for joining us today. Rise up, overcomer, and have a great day.
Please bow your heads in prayer. Lord Heavenly Father, we ask that you continue to bless our circle of sisters of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated into another glorious new program year. Father God, we pray for a safe, successful, and prosperous new school year, and we ask that you give us a clean heart and renew a fresh spirit within us. Eternal God, in this challenging world as we face barriers that seem insurmountable, we ask that you fill us with your power so that we can rise up and overcome any obstacle and survive any storm with victory and success. We ask that you give us the strength we need to run the race set before us. Father God, we give you the praise for the gift of service, that we may continue to represent you in all that we do and say. And now, as we prepare to depart today, we pray for your spirit to lead us each step of this upcoming season. We ask that you guide our decisions, stand close, order our direct steps, and protect us in all that we do. We ask that you will open doors needing to be open and close the ones needing to be shut tight. May the legacy and connectiveness of this great sisterhood inspire us to carry out your spirit of peace, love, harmony, and hope to all who cross our paths. Embolden us to selflessly let our light shine and be the good fruits in the lives of other women and our community. Bless our leadership and bless each sister in attendance. These blessings we ask in your name, in the name of Jesus Christ, let us all say amen.